Welcome. It's good to be back with you again. The Senate is now through voting on bills that originated in the Senate, with the exception of those necessary to implement budgets. We commonly refer to it as cutoff. In all, the Senate passed 223 pieces of Senate legislation. Some of the most worthwhile pieces waited until the final days before the deadline. For example, workers' comp reform. It includes voluntary settlements passed with bipartisan support, but we're unsure at this time how it will fare in the House. But it is important to remember that in the state of Washington, a comparable business pays 80% more in industrial insurance than our neighbors in Idaho. We need to reform the system to remain competitive, to keep people working, to keep businesses on our side of the state. One of the other positive trends from this was a constitutional amendment to put extraordinary revenue in our constitutionally protected rainy day fund. Had we taken these actions earlier, we certainly wouldn't be in as deep a mess as we are today. Of course, there are also bills that passed that concern me. TransAlta basically was forced into an agreement to accelerate conversion to a gas-fired plant. This is troubling in that they produce 10% of the electricity generated in the state of Washington. They already had an agreement with the governor to voluntarily move into a cleaner burning system. Now, existing generation is certainly cheaper than any form of new generation we can bring online. That's bad for consumers, especially low-income consumers, and not good for jobs in the state of Washington. So I felt that this was unnecessary legislation at this time. Another area of concern was medical marijuana. I understand the intent, but law enforcement has brought us concerns about impaired drivers, children, and the fact that federally it's still not legal. So there are concerns about that. And, you know, sometimes some good bills just don't come up for a vote because there isn't enough time or details haven't worked out. In a previous update, I talked to you about a mentioned livestock water quality bill. Well, we worked the bill hard. In fact, we had support from, believe it or not, the Department of Ecology and many prominent members across the other side of the aisle. But with that, we just ran out of time to get it through, so it's something we have to look at for a future session. Another idea that I think the public would support is a constitutional amendment to allow for midterm salary reductions for elected officials. It also didn't pass before the deadline, so is that necessary to implement the budget or not? I think you could make a case either way. But I think if we're going to ask public employees to take a reduction, elected officials certainly should be willing to do the same. So starting this week past cutoff, we go back to committee meetings and we'll be considering the bills that passed the House. So we're moving on with that. One of the discussions still out ahead of us in remaining weeks is tax incentives. Some people believe that they should be on the ballot to the voters. Others say we need to live within our means. As always, I enjoy hearing from you on these issues. If you'd like a preview of that conversation, go online to Washington's TVW Inside Olympia with myself and Reuven Carlisle, a Democrat colleague from Seattle, for a thoughtful discussion on this. Again, if you have questions or comments, my contact information is listed below, and I look forward to seeing you next week.